Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel ERUD Teaches. Thank you for coming back in today's tutorial. I'm so So today in our tutorial, we are going to learn how to cut this flame. This is a 1080 flame. That is three full flames joined together, and this is the outcome of it. You see how fine it looks. So I'm going to teach you how to cut and sew this particular flame. For those of you that have subscribed, I say thank you for subscribing. And those that have not subscribed, please I'm begging you, please click that subscribe button to subscribe to support my channel, and also notification bell so that you'll be notified whenever I upload a new. Thank you. Let's go to the cutting table.
This is the fabric we'll be using. So now we are going to determine the radius. And how do we determine the radius when we are cutting and 1080 degree flame? So what we'll do is the waist measurement, because 1080 flame is just three full flames. That's a 360 into 3, that's 1080. So that means we are going to divide the waist measurement in round waist circumference by, whatever we get, we divide it by 6.28, or we divide the round waist measurement by 6.28, whatever we get, we divide it by 3. Whichever way you go about it, we still arrive at the same. So now, I'm going to, the round waist circumference I'm using is 40 inches. So 40 is divided by 6.28 will give me 6.36. So that 6.36, I will divide it by 3, since I'm cutting 3 full flames. So when I divided it by 3, it gave me 2.12. That is my radius. 2.12. That is my radius. Now, the length of the flare I'm working with is 9 inches, inclusive the seam allowance. So that 9 inches, now I'm going to add that my 2.12 to it. So that my 2.9 inches plus 2.12 inches will give me 11.12 inches. So I'm going to fold my fabrics with 11.12 inches now. This is my folding. It is to have 12.5 inches here. So now I'm going to fold it again, because it's a full, when you're cutting full circle, you fold into 4. So this is 2 folding. I'm going to fold to get my 4 folding. I have 12 inches here. So now I'm going to measure my radius. Remember, my radius is 2.12. So I'm going to measure my 2.12 here now. 2.12. I'll just measure it round. I've measured my radius. Now from this, my radius now, my peplum, remember I said the peplum I'm using is my peplum length is 9 inches, so I'm measuring my 9 inches here now. 9 inches. So now I've measured my peplum length now, my flare length. So now I'm going to cut it out. I'll first cut out from my radius. Now I'm cutting my flare length now. is what I have.
So I'm going to use this now to cut two more.
So I'm done cutting out the three. This is 1, 2, 3. So I'm
going to use this now to cut out my lining and also my interface, because I have to bond my interface on it. If you have a hair stay is fine, but it's depending on what the customer paid. So I'm going to use this paper stay for mine now. If you can get this one in your area where you're staying, it's better. But I couldn't get this in my area, so I have to go for this. Then I will cut this paper stay now, cut 6 of it, using this to cut it at 6. And the lining, I will cut 3. I'm done cutting the paper stay. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You see, I didn't cut out the radius. I will cut out the radius when I'm done gumming it on my lining and on my fabrics. That's my lining, 1, 2, 3. I didn't cut out the radius also. I will cut it out when I'm done gumming the paper stay on it. That's when I will cut out the radius. What I'm going to do now is to use my iron to gum all these things on both my fabrics and my lining. I'm done gumming the paper stay to the lining and also to the fabrics. As you can see now, there are some excesses at the edge, so I'm going to trim it off. The same thing at the fabrics. You can see that there are some excesses of the paper. I'll trim it off. Then when I'm done trimming it off, I'll put it this way. Now cut out this one on the radius. Then I will now use it to cut out the radius of the lining. Okay, you can see I've cut out the excess. See what I did? I pinned the lining and the fabrics together so that everything will be equal. So now that I'm done cutting it out, so what I will do now is I'll fold it this way to make sure that it's equal. I've got make sure that they are equal. I can now cut the radius. So I will now cut this radius here. This is what I have now. So this is what I have now for the three. Each has lining. Let's see. I have 3 flares here. Each has inside. So now I'm going to cut it open. But there's something I noticed in this my flare now. If you look at this my flare very well, you see that they have this pattern on one side of it. So I'm going to take note of it so that everything will look fine. If you are working with clothes that has pattern, you have to take note of the pattern where you are working with. So now what I want to do now is I will fold it through this pattern. From this pattern side is where I will cut it open. Okay, I'm done cutting it open. This is what I have now. So I'm going to join the three together, lining to lining, fabric to fabric. I'm going to remove all this lining here and the three lining together, and also join the three fabrics together. This, I'll join one here, then on this side now, I'll join another one on this side. So this is how we do it. Okay, I'm done joining, and this is what I have now. I'm joining the fabrics together.
is what I have. You can see it. I'm loving this. So I'll join my lining. I still giving me the same results. And I've also ironed. I want to show you something. I've ironed where I joined it together. Look at what here. I opened an iron. So now I'm going to put them together, right side facing each other. Right side facing each other. So what I'm going to do now is I'll bring the two together this way. This together. Go the down with half inch seam allowance all through. Okay, joining here. So the next thing that I'll do now is to notch it. I'll notch it this way all round. Okay, I'm done notching it all round. So now I'm going to top stitch. What I'm going to do now is turn it to the right side. When I turn it to the right side this way, so I will keep put it in my machine. I'll make sure that this savage here is on the lining side, and I will not top stitch it all around. I'm done top stitching. You see how neat it is. This is front. I've ironed it. You see our peplum, very relaxed, very beautiful. There's something I forgot to tell you. By the time you join your peplum together, if you measure your round wear circumference, if you have excess on this your round wear circumference, you just cut it out, because in when you're doing from 720 flame wears, there is sometimes there is excess. So you cut it out before you turn your flame. So now what I'm going to do now, turn it this way. The two edges, I'll turn it this way. But before I do that, I'll check my round waist circumference if it's okay. If it's not okay, I'll cut out the excess. Then I'll turn it this way and join. And I will also turn it this way and join on this side. So this is the final result. 180 flame. See the way it is. This is it. You see how wavy. I didn't even put cream on it, and look at the way it is. So the next thing now is attach it to your half length. So this brings us to the end of this tutorial. So if this video has been helpful, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up, like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel, ERUD Stitches on YouTube. You can follow us on Facebook. Our Facebook group is ERUD Stitches, and our Facebook page is Elegant Stitches. You can also join our Telegram group at 080-977-53045. You will also see us in Instagram at ifeyinwa patience. Thank you for watching till the end. Bye.